and welcome to Half a Broadcast. I'm so excited to be here with Anuja Chauhan, who needs very little introduction, I have to say. And it's amazing. You were just saying it's been 10 years that you've been a full-time writer.
Yes.
5 books in that period of time. Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, it's been great fun. I mean, I just really, it's so nice to love what you do so much. And I really like writing, and I'm very happy doing this full time.
And you know, before this, of course, you were like in advertising, which I think also many of us find fascinating because some of the catchphrases of our generation, you've been part of that. Could I ask you a couple of things? One is, as an advertiser, what's your favorite sort of phrase?
As an advertiser?
Or with your advertising hat on? Yeh dil mange mo, any of the ones that you were associated with?
Oh, and something that I wrote?
Yeah.
Out of the ones I write, the one I like best is Mera Number Kab Aayega.
Oh, nice.
Which is very plaintive and wistful and somehow so relevant.
Yeah.
You know, even now it just seems to work in my life. I seem to always be saying it.
It just seems to capture a generation, I feel like. Now some of these lines just, they become a touch
point.
Yeah,
they do. Like, Edil Mange Mo has been like the liberalization cry in a sense, which is very little to do with me because just, I think the phrase just fitted the mood of the nation at the moment, and that's when we were opening up and that's what everybody wanted, unabashedly asking for more.
That sort of translates into writing, because the other thing is that you've struck a chord with so many readers. That's not always easy for a writer to do, you know, to capture something that sort of resonates across the board.
See, I write to please myself. Mm-hmm. As there seem to be more and more books which I've written, obviously there's some kind of benchmark that happens. But yeah, when you write a book, you always, you know, when the last page ends, people, if the reaction is Yedil Mange Mo, then that's perfect, really. You know, like people are saying, oh, I saw the pages thinning towards the end and I felt it's soon going to be over, which is a lovely kind of feedback to get.
Yeah.
That's something that I always feel I'm reading a book I love. They're like, oh God, it's getting over. Let me ration this a little.
Yeah. So the book you're working on now, Baz, will you tell us a little bit?
So Baz is, it's again like slightly period, it's set in 1971, but the thing is, you know, the liberation war for Bangladesh, and it's strange. I mean, it is so many years ago, but it still feels very relevant. I mean, we still have this whole thing of the whole refugee situation, people coming into your country, you're responsible for them, all the same. Actually, it's the same conversation that happens again and again, so I still feel it feels very relevant.
Yeah.
It's a much more idealistic time. I think I wanted to write about fighter pilots and, you know, how they're so cool and they're so cocky and so top gunnish, as well as a lot of them are from it's a very mixed bag, you know. Some of them are from royal families and they're really rich and they're youngest, and some of them have just been recruited straight out of the Khets of Haryana, you know. So it's a nice mixed bunch of boys to work with. I'm really enjoying writing about boys because Pricey Thakur Girls and How's That BJ Built were all about girls.
Yeah.
So I'm loving that.
How do you feel about adaptations?
I don't know. Well, not very good. But I love the money. I'm not very sure. Because you need money. Hey, you guys barely pay.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's great. And of course, it opens you up to a much wider audience as well. But the thing is that it's never, personally, as a reader, I'm never very happy with the movies.
So what do you want to tell your fans, though, the ones who are like probably going to want to watch your movies? Anything, any words,
a message? No, I would say, like, for the purest narrative, I mean, my vision, I would say read the book, because that has the, you know, I mean, that's what I said. After that, subsequently, of course, there's so many calls when a movie's made, right? There are stars and the dates and the prices and there are all kinds of constraints, the political outfits, you know, you have to, like, in a book you can say anything.
Yeah.
But in a film you have to be so much more careful because so many people are looking at you. So I think that for the purest vision of the author, you should always read the book, not just my book, any book.